Good morning, Tucson. Welcome to Mineral City TV. I'm your host, Raymond Hall.
I'm never joking.
It's opening day here at Mineral City. Dealers are open and the halls are packed. We're going to start today in Building D. We're going to meet another fantastic dealer here, Spirifer Minerals, in room D28. Spirifer is based out of Poland, and they travel the world finding new acquisitions every year, and he's going to show us around the room and show us what he's brought new this year. Come on inside. Hello, Tomek.
Hello, what a surprise.
What a surprise. And for those that don't know, this is the man behind Mineral City TV. This was all his idea and his doing. So it's a pleasure to actually have him on the show. Tell us a little bit about Spirifer.
So our company based in Tucson, Arizona, but we are from Poland and we travel all around the world hunting for minerals, digging minerals. We specialize in such countries as Morocco, Madagascar, Mongolia, recently Congo, but also several other places where we go quite frequently. And we specialize in bringing some new finds, some unusual material to the market. And I would like to show you a few things which we brought this time.
All right, awesome. Let's see it.
Let's start with something quite ugly but interesting. The chalcocites from Congo, from Passa mine. This is Congo Brazzaville, not mixed up with other Congo, which is called Democratic Republic of Congo. And Passa mine is a location which was operating in 70s and 80s. It was one of the biggest mines in Congo. And it was closed for last two or three decades. And recently, with growing demand for the ore, there is more and more people going underground, working half legally, let's say. And during the process of digging ore, they start to find the pockets with chalcocites. And what's interesting about these chalcocites is that they are formed in really big crystals. Most of them are maybe not super sharp, but look on the size of the crystals.
That
this is
really huge.
Unique for the species and with quite decent luster.
That's what I was just about to say. They've got really nice luster. Even here where there's not a lot of light outside of the case, you can still see the flash on the faces.
And there were found also some smaller pieces which are much more sharp. Some of them with syntaxial growth, some of them associated with pyrite. So as you know, chalcocite is maybe a common mineral as an ore mineral, but it's quite rare to
see it in form specimen form.
Specimens and crystals.
Very cool.
So the other thing, it's in fact single specimen we brought here, but it's very special. This is the aragonite, known as flossferry, which was collected as recently as last year in Laurion mines in Greece, which are very famous for secondary zinc, copper minerals. And this is probably the best specimen coming from Laurion.
It's just amazing. And I'm sure the people at home can't really get a sense of how big it is. I'm going to put my hand in front of it. That's not helping either.
You can put it
maybe
behind.
It is huge. I mean, it's got, what's the
40
centimeters?
Yeah. It's in fact a miracle that it was possible to transport it from Greece to Poland and then here.
I'm sure it's a nightmare every time you have to move it.
Yeah, it's not fun to pack things like that.
All right, well, everyone that knows me knows how much I love tourmaline. Always been my favorite, and there's been a new find. Tell us about the new find of tourmaline.
So, in fact, Morocco became a tourmaline producer for already several years. And most of the pieces found there were interesting, they were nice for Morocco, but they were never as good as the ones coming from Brazil or other countries. And in 2020, there was discovered pocket, which we called candy cane pocket, which contains this beautiful reddish, pinkish, cranberry color albites associated with snow white microclines. With some minor albite and quartz. And we consider that as the best pocket of tourmalines ever found in Morocco as far.
They're really astoundingly beautiful, especially the ones on the microlines. The contrast, you know, on the matrix is amazing.
Some of them are doubly terminated, and really for Morocco is something you would not expect. And this area is quite productive, and we hope there will be more finds in the future. Geologically, it's similar, the conditions of growth, and they're similar to the tourmalines from Elba, and many specimens reminds the classic ones from Elba.
Sure. Are those ones in the back corner there from the same pocket, or are those a different pocket?
The pieces here, the three or four pieces here, are from different pockets.
Okay.
Much more typical for Morocco, and much more looking like Elba. For the first view, you would say this is Elba.
The zoning, yeah.
Yeah, but this is Moroccan, and this is much more classic stuff for Morocco.
Still very pretty. All right, we got a couple more things to show you, so let's keep moving. You brought a lot of new stuff this year.
So we've got small curiosity here. These are unusual marcasite specimens from Linwood mine collected last year, which form these unusual strings. We can call them pseudo-stalactites because these are not real stalactites. They are built up of quite well-formed crystals, some of them probably spinel low twinned, but I'm not quite sure about that. And they form these unusual formations, sometimes associated with calcite.
I doubt the sparkle is coming through on the camera here, but they really sparkle, and they were honestly the first thing that caught my eye when I walked into the room.
And talking about specimens, the last thing I would like to show you are the fluorites from the Larkin's Quarry in Ireland, Connemara. This is the granite quarry, which is the granites are cutted by veins with fluorite, quartz, chlorite, galena, sphalerite, and there are pockets with these usually purple blue fluorites with phantoms and very interesting color zoning. But recently they hit the zone where there was found several very big crystals as big as 20 centimeters on the edge with octahedral purple phantom in the core, then blue zone, and then green corners. The specimen which Marek is filming now is about 20 centimeters across.
Yeah, they are huge cubes, and the zoning is incredible. It reminds me of some, you know, older Chinese material I've seen, but nothing from Ireland like that for sure.
So for the end, I would like to show you something mineral related, but not minerals sensu stricto. My friend, geologist from Poland, mineralogist Justyna Domańska-Siuda, she's a professor at Warsaw University Geology Department. She's also an artist, and she started to produce the pottery, handmade pottery, with minerals. And this pottery is branded by Mineral Museum, you can see here, and the profit from sale of this pottery is going to help to construct the museum which we do in Poland.
They are really cool. I'm sure a lot of work goes into them.
Okay,
well,
so
Tomek, that was great. Thank you so much for giving us a tour of your room, and thank you for putting Mineral City TV together too, because there's a lot of people out there that are really happy that these shows are going on, and they really appreciate all the work that you're putting into it. So,
right, thank you. You are the best host we can have, and it's really going very
thank
well.
Thank you. Yep,
and
thank
I
you.
Hope we'll continue.
All right, awesome.
Thank you, guys.
Everyone, see you at 1 p.m. Mountain Time. We'll introduce you to another dealer here at Mineral City on opening day.